Okay, it is working. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. If you remember last year we spoke about the prophets alayhim salatu wasalam. We started with Adam, then Nuh, then Hud, and after Hud Saleh and Shu'aib, and the last one we discussed last year about Lut alayhi salatu wasalam. Inshallah, in this Ramadan I will discuss the story of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam is the third father. They say Adam is Abu al-Bashr, the father of all humanity. Adam, the first man, Adam. No one is before him. I mean, as a human being. Yes, there was jinn before him, and also the angels before Adam, no doubt. Okay, but as a human being, as insan, bashar, Adam is the first one. And we discuss this because, you know, some people claim that there were people before Adam. Adam is not the first human being, and this is all of this wrong. So Adam is the father of all human beings. Abu al-Bashar, Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. And also, if you remember, we said Nuh also is the second father. Why? Because Allah said in the Quran, وَجَعَلْنَا ذُرِّيَّتَهُ هُمُ الْبَاقِينَ وَجَعَلْنَا ذُرِّيَّتَهُ هُمُ الْبَاقِينَ. After Allah, you know, Allah saved Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam and the believers with Nuh. But subhanAllah, only the children of Nuh who lived after him, who have the children, only from the siblings of Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. They were men with him, but all of them did not have children except Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. So all the human beings now, children of Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. All of them children of Nuh. So that's why they call him Adam al-Thani, the second Adam. And also some of the scholars said Ibrahim also is the third Adam. Why? Because all the prophets from him alayhi salatu wasalam. All the prophets from Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Okay, Ibrahim, then Ismail and Ishaq. From Ismail, only Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Only Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay, from Ismail, there is no prophet between Ismail and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the last prophet. And from Ishaq, Ismail, Ishaq, both of them children of Ibrahim. From Ishaq, Yaqub, and from Yaqub, Bani Israel. Yusuf, Musa, Isa, Dawood, Zakariya, Yahya, all of the prophets from Ishaq. So that's alayhi salatu wasalam. So that's why they say Ibrahim is the third Adam. Ibrahim is the third Adam. Or they call him Abu al-Anbiya, the father of the prophets. The father of the prophets. Allah said about Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, Inna Ibrahim kana ummatan qanitan lillahi hanifan walam yakun minal mushrikeen. Okay, يعني سبحان الله. If you notice, there is special care about Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. And also, you will find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam to follow only the millah of Ibrahim. To follow the millah. What does it mean millah? The way. تبع ملة إبراهيم. Okay. And also, in our du'a in the morning, what we say? أصبحنا على فطرة الإسلام وعلى كلمة الإخلاص وعلى دين نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى ملة أبينا إبراهيم. If you notice, there is something special about Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام. We have to follow the millah of Ibrahim. What is the meaning of millah? The religion, deen, or the way. Millah. طيب. So Allah says about Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام, إن إبراهيم كان أمة. طيب. The word أمة means, in the Quran, it came the Quran with about four meanings. Ummah. And this is very important. I mentioned this yesterday in the tafsir class that it is very important to know the meanings of the word. And yesterday I gave an example, the word Ayn. Ayn. What is the meaning of Ayn? It depends. It depends. What is the context of this sentence and this word? For example, if I say I have pain in my eye, it means this eye. Or you can say also the eye of the needle. So it depends where is the sentence, where is the word in the sentence. Okay, so this is very important to understand the Quran, because the Quran is Arabic. Okay, so this is very important. So the word ummah, it came in the Quran with about four meanings. The word ummah. For example, Allah says in Surah Yusuf, alayhi salatu wasalam, you remember the story when Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam entered the jail and he met two people and he explained the dream for them. Sah? Okay. So one of them killed, sah? And the other one saved. يسقي الملك, he will save the king and he will be free. Okay, so the one who was free, Allah said about him, وقال الذي نجا منهما, the one who was saved said, وقال الذي نجا منهما وذكر بعد أمة. بعد أمة. Okay, what is the meaning of the word أمة here? It means a time. It means time. So the word ummah here, it tells you there is time, period of time. Okay, so this is the first meaning, ummah. The second meaning, ummah, it means, as we mentioned, ummah means millah, way. It means a religion, a way. In also Allah mentioned this word in the Quran about the kuffar. When you tell the kuffar, why you are worshipping the idols? Why you are not worshipping Allah alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala? They will say, "Inna wajadna abana ala ummah," because we found our forefathers doing this way. "Inna wajadna abana ala ummah." Okay? So this is the second meaning. Ummah means a way. The third meaning, the story of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, when he left Egypt and he escaped. Where? Madian. وَلَمَّا وَرَدَ مَاءَ مَدِيَنَا. Okay, when he saw the two girls. Okay. وَلَمَّا وَرَدَ مَاءَ مَدِيَنَا وَجَدَ عَلَيْهِ أُمَّةً مِّنَ النَّاسِ يَسْقُونَ. He found ummah. It means a group of people. See the beauty of the Quran. And this is very important to understand the Arabic language, to understand the Quran. وَجَدَ عَلَيْهِ أُمَّةً. He found group. And the fourth meaning of the word ummah in this ayah, okay, Allah says about Ibrahim, "Inna Ibrahim kana ummatan." Ibrahim is like ummah, or Ibrahim is an ummah. Okay, what is the meaning of ummah? Some scholars said here it means the leader. Ummah means the leader who has all the good attributes and criteria. They say اجتمعت فيه خصال الخير. All the good attributes will be found in him. Al-Imam al-Muttaba', who is followed. And that's why we follow Ibrahim, alayhi salatu wasalam. Okay? So subhanAllah, it is only one word, but it has different meanings. So this is very important to understand the Quran. Okay, very important to understand the Quran. So Allah said about Ibrahim in this ayah, in Surah An-Nahl, verse number 121, إِنَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ كَانَ أُمَّةً. So this is the first criteria. Ummah, it means a leader. All the good criteria in Ibrahim will be found in Ibrahim. قَانِتًا لِلَّهِ. طيب. This is the second. قَانِتًا لِلَّهِ. طيب. What does it mean, القنوت? Okay. Also the same thing. القنوت has different meanings. For example, in Witr, what we say? دعاء القنوت. It means the دعاء in the witr, the dua in the witr. Okay, and this dua can be before the ruku' or after ruku'. One of the brothers asked me yesterday or the day before, and I mentioned this also on Instagram. Okay, the dua of witr can be before ruku' or after ruku'. It's okay. Okay, yes, now almost all of our masajid, the dua when? After ruku'. But one of the brothers told me there is a masjid, they make the dua before ruku'. I don't know which area. Sami or Mabul, I don't know which area exactly. And also the Sheikh Al-Albani mentioned, this is the sunnah. He said, for the witr, the dua should be before ruku'. And for the fard, the dua after ruku'. What is the meaning of fard? They call it dua al-nazila. If there is a problem for the Muslim ummah, okay, then the imam, all the imam in the masajid, they make dua. For example, for the Muslims in the east or the west, in any country, if there is a problem, or in the same country, you make dua after ruku'. You make the dua after ruku'. So the qunut means the dua. We mean the dua in the witr, okay, before ruku'. And also, if you want to make dua before ruku', قل هو الله يريد, for example, in the witr, the last rak'ah, قل هو الله أحد, الله الصمد, لم يلد ولم يولد, ولم يكن له كفوا أحد, الله أكبر, then you make dua. Then you make another الله أكبر for ruku'. طيب. Okay, here, what does it mean for qunut? Qunut means he continuously worship Allah. Al-qunut هو دوام الطاعة. Continuously obeying Allah. Qunut means dawam al-ta'ah. Okay? So Ibrahim was obeying Allah continuously. He will not stop obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no time to obey Allah and another time to disobey Allah. No. All of his life, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسْكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. My life for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also my death, my salah, my sacrifice, everything for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, so this is number two, qanitan. And also there is very important word here. Allah did not say qanitan and that's it. Qanitan lillah. It means sincerity, ikhlas. Okay, so this is very important. Qanitan lillah, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then at the end, وَلَمْ يَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. Okay, قَانِتًا لِلَّهِ. Maybe someone will say, this is enough. قَانِتًا لِلَّهِ, it means sincerity. But Allah also emphasized this. وَلَمْ يَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. He was not mushrik. And there is a rule that the scholars, this consensus, ijma', the prophets عليهم الصلاة والسلام will not commit shirk. This is very important. Why? Because sometimes when you read the stories of the prophets, you will find a lot of narrations, not from the Sunnah. From where? Israeliyat, from Ahlul Kitab. Okay? And these narrations we are not sure. We are not sure about. But as we mentioned before, if you remember, we said, the Prophet ﷺ said, حَدِّثُ عَنْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ وَلَا حَرَجْ. If you like to narrate from the stories of Bani Israel, from their books, it's okay, no problem. But you have to be careful. Why? Because we, as Muslims, we believe these books changed. They have changes. Okay, and they have very bad meanings. If you remember when you spoke about Lut, عليه الصلاة والسلام, they accused Lut that he did zina with his daughters. A'udhu billah. He did adultery with his daughters. A'udhu billah. This is major sin. The prophets cannot, will not be do major sins. And also this is not authentic. Not authentic. So, if you like to narrate from the people of the book, okay, the Israeliyat, it's okay. But you have to be careful that the stories are not contradicting the Quran. Okay? Because many information in their books contradict the Quran. For example, who is at the bih? At the bih. Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam, the one who Ibrahim alayhi salatu, it is mentioned in the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Ibrahim, slaughter your son. Okay? and the ayat, okay, supports the opinion that Ismail was a dhabih. But because they don't like the Ismail lineage, the Arab side, they say no, he is Ishaq. He was Ishaq. Okay? So some Muslims take from them. Okay, no, we believe he is Ismail. Yes, there are different opinions, but the proofs support that dhabih is Ismail alayhi salatu wassalam. Okay? So this very important criteria of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam. إن إبراهيم كان أمة sorry I missed one of them sorry إن إبراهيم كان أمة قانتا لله حنيفا حنيفا ولم يكن من المشركين. Okay, what is the meaning of حنيف? حنيف means موحد. It means he doesn't have any shirk. Okay, they say مائلا عن الشرك إلى التوحيد. He's avoiding the shirk, going toward the توحيد. حنيف. Okay, مقابل التوحيد. He is facing the توحيد. Okay, there is a disease called الحنف. There is a disease called الحنف. What does it mean, الحنف? Huh? No, no, as a disease. Subhanallah, some people, because of Allah, maybe lack of calcium or a problem in the vitamin D, you will notice the knees going to inside. Huh? Yes, bending to inside. Okay, so these are the normal man, okay, the legs, but because of problem, his knees going inside, so when he walks, subhanallah, يعني, yes, the knee touches the other one.
Knocking the knees.
Yes. So this is called al-hanaf. Al-hanaf. It means the knee faces the other knee. Okay, so al-hanaf means he is facing the tawheed, alayhi salatu wasalam, Ibrahim. And there is hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw a man, his dress long, below the ankle. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, make it shorter. This man said, oh Rasulullah, I am ahnaf. I have this problem, hanaf. So when I walk, my knees touch each other. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Inna kulla khalq Allah hasan." All the creatures of Allah are good. Okay, don't worry. Don't worry. Why you feel shame? This is the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Allah said also about Ibrahim, "Shakiran li an'umih." Okay, he was thanking Allah subhanahu wa taala for his favors. شاكرا لنعمه اجتباه. Allah chose Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام and guided him to الصراط المستقيم. Allah guided Ibrahim to الصراط المستقيم. And also in Surah Ali Imran, Allah says, إن الله اصطفى آدم ونوحا وآل إبراهيم وآل عمران على العالمين. They were, يعني Allah chose them. إن الله اصطفى آدم وإبراهيم إن الله اصطفى آدم ونوحا وآل إبراهيم وآل عمران على العالمين. طيب الله mentioned إبراهيم in the Quran many times, about 70 times the name of إبراهيم عليه الصلاة والسلام, and this tells you the importance of إبراهيم عليه الصلاة والسلام. And also the same thing موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام. Okay, he was mentioned more than إبراهيم عليه الصلاة والسلام. And some people think that the Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام was mentioned more than the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the Quran, and this is wrong. Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم was mentioned more in the Quran, but as a name, yes, it is less. How many times in the Quran the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم? 4 times, and 1 time as Ahmed, مبشرا برسول يأتي من بعدي اسمه أحمد. So the name Muhammad found in the Quran 4 times. And you can add one as Ahmed. So we can say the Prophet ﷺ mentioned by his name how many times in the Quran? 5 times. 5 times. And Ibrahim, about 70 times. Musa, more than 150 or something like this. So many times mentioned the Quran. What is the name of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam? Ibrahim ibn Azar. Ibrahim is the son of Azar. Why we said his father is Azar? Because clearly it is mentioned in the Quran. Allah says in the Quran, وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ لِأَبِيهِ آزَر. So it is very clear in the Quran that his name is Azar. And also, in the hadith, in the Bukhari, the Prophet ﷺ said Ibrahim will meet his father Azar. So it is clear. يَلْقَى إِبْرَاهِيمُ أَبَاهُ آزَر يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Ibrahim will meet his father Azar at the day of judgment. So this is very clear in the Quran. Subhanallah, yesterday, my son prayed in masjid, not here. So the Sheikh gave lecture and he said, because Abdurrahman told me after the halqa what he heard from this Sheikh, he said, this Sheikh said, Ibrahim, Azar is not the father of Ibrahim. Okay? He is his uncle, Azar. Azar, the uncle of Ibrahim. My son told me, I left the masjid, I did not continue. Subhanallah, the problem, people are misusing some of the Arabic language rules. They say, Azar is the uncle of Ibrahim. And this is possible in the Quran, this is possible in the Arabic language. Okay, but you have to mention the complete rule. Now, if I say, this is my father, khalas, he is my father. I don't mean he is my uncle. But in certain places, we can say the word father means uncle. Like in Surah Al-Baqarah, Ya'qub alayhi salatu wasalam said, وَاتَّبَعْتُ مِلَّةَ آبَائِي إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَعِيلَ وَإِسْحَاقَ. Okay, Ya'qub mentioned, Allah mentioned about Ya'qub that he said, my fathers, Ibrahim, Ismail, and Ishaq. Okay? So he said the word fathers, Abai. Ibrahim, can you say to your grandfather as father? Yes, no problem. I can call my grandfather Abati, no problem. And Ishaq is the father of Yaqub? Yes, the direct father. Okay, what about Ismail? His uncle. Okay, so generally, if you mention a group, can you include your uncle as father? Yes. But about Ibrahim, Allah said, وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ لِأَبِيهِ آزَر. So no need to say it is his uncle. Okay, no need. And we have also another proof in Bukhari, as I mentioned the hadith. Okay, why they want to say that Ibrahim is not the son of Azar? Azar is his uncle, because they have a belief. This is the problem. The problem, sometimes people have a belief and they try to twist the proofs to go with their beliefs. Okay, so what is their belief? Their belief, some people, misguided groups, their belief, all the prophets should come from pure origin. So we cannot say that the father of Ibrahim is mushrik, because shirk is najasa, is impurity. So what can we do? Let's say he is the uncle of Ibrahim. And also about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, this sheikh, he mentioned the lecture yesterday, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, my father in the fire, the hellfire, he means his uncle. Okay, from where you have this explanation? Because they believe we cannot say the father of the Prophet ﷺ is mushrik. How can we say the Prophet ﷺ came from a shirk? Yani, what is the relation? What is the relation? Yani, the point is that the Prophet himself, he's muwahhid, no doubt. His father is mushrik, not mushrik. This will not affect the Prophet. If your father is not Muslim, if your son is not Muslim, your wife not Muslim, this will not affect you. Khalas, Allah will ask you about your deeds. Okay, Allah will not account you about your parents. Why your parents mushrik? Allah will not ask you why your parents or your grandparents are mushrik. Okay, so we have to believe that the name of the father of Ibrahim is Azar. Why? Because Allah mentioned it in the Quran. It is mentioned clearly in the Quran.
Some people say that Azar
شوف in the books of the يعني the Jews or Christians they mention that the name of the father of Ibrahim is Tareh. Tareh. Okay? And okay, how they say the name is Tareh and in the Quran Azar? First of all, we have to follow the Quran and our Sunnah. So it is mentioned Azar, that's it, Azar. But some scholars said one of them is nickname and one is the real name. يعني maybe the nickname is Tareh and his the nickname is Azar and the name is Tareh or the opposite. Okay, but we have to take it simply as Allah mentioned it in the Quran. His name is Azar. The title is Azar for anyone. We need a proof for this. We need a proof for this. Why? Because we have in the Quran clear verse and the clear hadith that the name of the father is Azar. Okay. What is the hadith in the Sunnah about the father of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam? As I mentioned, يلقى إبراهيم. Ibrahim will meet his father Azar at the day of judgment. وعلى وجهه غبر وقترة. On the face of Azar, غبر وفجر. غبر وقترة. يعني like dust. And يعني سبحان الله bad face. فيقول له إبراهيم. Then Ibrahim will tell his father, oh dad, did not I tell you, don't disobey me, follow me, obey me. Then Azar will tell his son Ibrahim, today I will obey you. Whatever you are saying to me, I will obey you. The time has finished. Subhanallah, all the kuffar at the moment of death, they will claim, khalas, yalla, I will give charity, I will pray, I will become Muslim. But the time, done. Finish. Subhanallah. So Azar will say, oh my son, I will obey you now. Whatever you are saying, I am following you. فَالْيَوْمَ عَصِيكَ. Then Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam will say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh my Lord, you promised me that you will not make me يعني feel bad at the day of judgment. وَلَا تُخْزِنِي يَوْمَ يُبْعَثُونَ. And oh Allah, the worst thing to see my father in this situation, he will be in the hellfire. Then Allah will say, إِنِّي حَرَّمْتُ الْجَنَّةَ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ. The Jannah is haram, is forbidden for the kuffar to enter the paradise. Another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَنْ يَدْخُلَ الْجَنَّةِ إِلَّا نَفْسٌ مُؤْمِنَةٌ. None will enter the paradise except the believing soul. Only the believers. The kuffar will not enter. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, حَتَّى يَلِجَ الْجَمَلْ فِي سَمِّ الْخِيَاطِ. If the camel enters the eye of the needle, then the kuffar will enter the paradise. And this is impossible. Can the camel enter inside this needle? The eye of the needle? This is impossible. So it is impossible for the kuffar to enter the paradise. And please, brothers, sisters, don't feel sorry that يعني, this is not fair. Or Habibi, this is fair because it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is their problem. This is their problem. Don't be worried about them that they will be in the hellfire forever because this is not your job. But of course, our concern should be da'wah. And the dunya, our concern should be the da'wah. We should give them da'wah. We should try our best to bring them to Islam. Like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was trying with his uncle Abu Talib until the last minute. He was telling him, Ya am, qul la ilaha illallah. Oh, uncle, say la ilaha illallah. Please, say la ilaha illallah. If you say la ilaha illallah, I can do something for you. But without la ilaha illallah, I cannot. So our job is to work, to make da'wah for them. But to judge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, why they will not enter the paradise, well, this is not our job, khalas. And you have to be sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another hadith that subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will change the shape of the father of Ibrahim to a shape of animal. فإذا هو ذيخ ملطخ بدم هيينة. Okay, why? Okay, some scholars said because Allah wants to make the issue, يعني if Allah punishes Azar as a shape of Azar, it will be very painful for Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام to see his father punished. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changed his shape to be an animal, hyena, dhikh, then subhanAllah, it is less for Ibrahim. يعني Allah wants to make it less for Ibrahim by changing the shape of his father Azar, dhikh, okay? Let's talk about Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. يعني we don't have anything from the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, how he was grow, the mother of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. But no doubt, subhanAllah, the community of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was full of shirk. Was full of shirk. And if you notice that in some verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that they were worshipping the idols. And other verses, we understand that they were worshipping the stars, the planets, the sun, the moon. Okay, and maybe there were two groups. Maybe there were two groups. One group worships the idols, and the other group worships the planets. The place of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, it is common that his place was Iraq, but no doubt he lived from Iraq to different places. Okay, we are sure that Ibrahim went to Egypt, and also we are sure that Ibrahim went to Mecca, no doubt. Okay, from where we have that he went to Egypt? Yes, the story of the king. He went, alayhi salatu wasalam, with his wife Sarah to Egypt, and he gave them Hajar, and Hajar from Egypt. Okay, and also, inshallah, it will come the story of building the Kaaba. So, no doubt he was in Mecca. طيب. So, these are the places where Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam went. They mention, in the Israeliyat from the people of the book, his father was making the idols. His job was making the idols. And they say he was sending his son Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam to the market to sell these idols, and Ibrahim was saying to people who likes to buy the things which la yadur wa la yanfa', who likes to buy something doesn't have benefit and also doesn't have harm, doesn't harm you and doesn't benefit you. Subhanallah, it was the fitrah, the nature of the human being, of the children. Subhanallah, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam is something special. Four groups agree on Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. If you notice, the Yahud loves Ibrahim. The Nasara also loves Ibrahim. Also the Mushriks and the Arab, also they love Ibrahim. And also, we as Muslims, no doubt, we love Ibrahim and we love all of them. So, subhanAllah, four groups. Muslims, Yahud, Nasara, Mushriks. That's why Ibrahim has something special. He's not like Isa, alayhi salatu wasalam. Because, subhanAllah, Yahud, they hate Isa, alayhi salatu wasalam. But Ibrahim, no, something special. And that's why Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, said in the Quran, in Surah Al-Baqarah, مَا كَانَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ يَهُودِيًّا وَلَا نَصْرَانِيًّا. Ibrahim was not Christian. Ibrahim was not Jew. Subhanallah. طيب, I mentioned this maybe more than one time. Can we say that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was Hanafi or Shafi'i? No one can accept this. But some people say this, huh? Huh? Sahaba? Sami? Anyone say this? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was Hanafi?
Sami saying that?
Maybe he knows someone. There was an old lady, our neighbor, when I was Desma. She passed away, Allah yarhamha. Okay, she said, the Prophet was Shafi'i. The Prophet was Shafi'i. Subhanallah. Okay, she was old lady. Alhamdulillah, Allah yarhamha. Ignorance, subhanallah. Ignorance, tayyib. So you love, if I say the Prophet was Hanbali or Shafi'i, This is not logic. So the same thing, can we say Ibrahim was a Christian? Impossible. Why? Because of Christianity? After Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. So everyone saying, no, Ibrahim belongs to us, Ibrahim belongs to us. The Yahud claim that Ibrahim belongs to us, and also the Nasara. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them, مَا كَانَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ يَهُودِيًّا وَلَا نَصْرَانِيًّا. So it is clear in the Quran, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was not Jew, was not Christian, ولكن, عليكم السلام, ولكن حَنِيفًا مُسْلِمًا. He was muwahid. He was worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. كان حنيفا مسلما. And I remember one of our colleagues in the hospital, he was Christian. So, he's a Christian, subhanAllah, Allah yahdi, may Allah guide him. He said, we are from the same tree. He means Ibrahim. He means Ibrahim. Okay, the same tree. Okay, they said the same tree. Follow the same tree. SubhanAllah. Allah Yahdi. So all of them, the Muslims, Christians, Jews, and the Mushrik, all of them agree on Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blamed the Yahud and Nasara. Ya ahl al-kitab, lima tuhajjuna fi Ibrahim, wa ma unzilat al-tawrat wal-injil illa min ba'dih. Why you are debating about Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam? And the Torah and Injil came after Ibrahim. أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. You don't have logic. SubhanAllah. Let's see the da'wah of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam. As we mentioned that Allah says about Ibrahim, إِنَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ كَانَ أُمَّةً قَانِثًا لِلَّهِ حَنِيفًا وَلَمْ يَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ شَاكِرًا لِأَنْعُمِهِ. Okay, اجتباه وهداه إلى صراط مستقيم. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وآتيناه في الدنيا حسنة وإنه في الآخرة لمن الصالحين. ثم أوحينا إليك أن اتبع ملة إبراهيم حنيفا وما كان المشركين. This is to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to follow the way of Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام. عليكم السلام. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قل إنني هداني ربي إلى صراط مستقيم دينا قيما ملة إبراهيم حنيفا. Allah told the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, خلاص. The way of Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام. Also Allah said to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, قل صدق الله فاتبعوا ملة إبراهيم حنيفا. Follow the way of Ibrahim. حنيفا يعني it means موحد. No shirk. Okay. Also Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, وجاهدوا في الله حق جهاده. هو اجتباكم. Allah chosen you. Has chosen you. وما جاء عليكم في الدين من حرج ملة أبيكم إبراهيم هو سماكم المسلمين. He named you as Muslims. Okay. Who named us as Muslims? Some scholars said the ayah means Allah. And other scholars said Ibrahim named us as Muslims. Okay. But the most stronger opinion, the first one, which means Allah. Allah named us as Muslims. Okay. Why? Allah says, "Inna al-Dina 'inda Allah al-Islam." Okay, all the prophets are Muslims. Adam, Nuh, Hud, and Salih, and Shu'ayb, and Isa, and Musa. All of them Muslims. All of them. Also Sulaiman. As this lady king said, "Wa aslamtu ma'a Sulaiman lillahi rabbil alamin." Okay, and I became Muslim with Sulaiman. طيب. And also to prove that Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام was not mushrik, when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم entered Mecca, okay, there were how many idols around the Kaaba? 360. SubhanAllah. And also when he entered inside the Kaaba, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he saw the pictures of Ibrahim and Ismail. They made pictures of Ibrahim and Ismail. And they were doing some shirk. استقسام the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم والله إن استقسم بالأزلام أبدا. When he entered inside the Kaaba, he saw the picture of Ibrahim and Ismail doing something called استقسام. Okay, what does mean استقسام? They used to do some a kind of shirk. يعني for example, if you want to travel, if you want to marry, if you want to buy something, okay, We as Muslims, we have something called istikhara. We have something called istikhara. For example, I'm going to buy a car, okay? And I chose this car, then I pray to rak'ah, then I make dua. So this is called dua istikhara. This is as Muslims. But as the kuffar, they used to do what? For example, in Mecca, they take a bird and they release the bird. If the bird went to the right, then this is okay. If the bird went to the left, this is not okay. If the bird went straight, repeat again. So this is one way. Another way, they put arrows. Okay, they choose, they put, for example, three arrows, and they choose randomly. They write something on every arrow. And they choose randomly. So what they get, they follow. So this is shirk. This is shirk. Okay, this is haram. As Muslims, we have something called istikhara. So they put a picture that Ibrahim and Ismail were doing istiqsam bil-azlam. So when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam entered inside the Kaaba, he said, by Allah, they did not do istiqsam. By Allah, this is not real. This is not real. But they claim that Ibrahim and Ismail were doing this thing. طيب. So what are the criteria of Ibrahim? In addition to what we mentioned, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chosen Ibrahim, has chosen Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, inna Allah astafa Adam wa Nuhan wa ala Ibrahima. Okay. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Ibrahim, wadhkur fil kitabi Ibrahim innahu kana siddiqan nabiyya. What does it mean siddiqan? It is also more than truthful. Okay. Truthful means sadiq. Sadiq. But siddiqan, it is always more, like Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. And subhanAllah, the level of Siddiq is very high level. Allah mentioned Surah An-Nisa, مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءَ وَالصَّالِحِينَ. The first and the highest level is prophethood, then Siddiqiyya, then Shuhada, then Salihin. So Ibrahim combined both of the first and second. So Allah said, صديقاً نبياً. صديقاً نبياً. طيب. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Ibrahim, وَلَقَدْ اصْطَفَيْنَاهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَإِنَّهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ لَمِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Also the fourth level. طيب. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Ibrahim, إِنَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ لَحَلِيمٌ أَوَّاهٌ مُنِيبٌ. Okay, Halim, this is also one of the criteria of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has names and attributes. Some of his names or and attributes only for him, and it is not allowed for us to use them for us. Okay, for example, Ar-Rahman. It is not allowed for you to name yourself Ar-Rahman. It's haram. But Ar-Rahim, we can use, صح? Can we use Ar-Rahim? For us or not? We can. What is the proof? Allah named the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam بالمؤمنين رؤوف الرحيم. So these names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, رؤوف الرحيم, and also names of or criteria of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So some of the names or some of the criteria can be used for the people, like al-Malik. It is mentioned in Surah Yusuf. وقال الملك إني أرى سبع بقرات سمان. I saw in the dream seven obese cows. And also the name Al-Aziz. This is also mentioned in the same Surah Yusuf. Umra'at Al-Aziz. Okay? So some of the names, some of the attributes can be used for the people, no problem. But some of them, no. Only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. So the word Al-Halim, okay, this is one of the names of Allah. What is the meaning of Al-Halim? Who gives time? Tolerant? Okay, yes. The one who can't punish, who can't punish, but he gives time. يعني, for repentance. So Allah, one of the names of Allah is Al-Halim. Allah can punish us. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of our sins. But he is patient, not punishing us. Why? He wants to give us time for tawbah, for repentance. So Ibrahim was halim. Inna Ibrahim lahalim. Okay. Awwah. What is the meaning of awwah? Okay. Yani it means who's asking Allah with the humility. Who's invoking Allah with the humility. Tadarru'. Tadarru', you know, when there's someone who's asking Allah, crying with humility. The third one, munib. Munib from inaba. It means tawbah, repentant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Ibrahim, إِذْ جَاءَ رَبَّهُ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Pure heart. Okay, this is very important criteria. That you have qalb salim. It is pure, clean from any kind of shirk. There is no envy toward any Muslim. There is no shirk. Qalb salim. Also, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ رُشْدَهُ مِنْ قَبْلِ وَكُنَّا بِهِ عَالِمِينَ. Okay? رُشْدَهُ, like, يعني, good way in thinking. يعني, subhanAllah, sometimes يعني, you notice wise. He is wise, subhanAllah, in doing the things. Okay? He knows what to do and what to avoid. And also, he was Rashidan, when he was young, Allah says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ رُشْدَهُ مِنْ قَبْلِ. Some scholars said, when he was young, subhanallah. And this will come, and when he was young, he was debating and arguing with his people about the shirk in a logic way, subhanallah. Also, Allah raised him. وَتِلْكَ حُجَّتُنَا آتَيْنَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ عَلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ نَرْفَعُ دَرَجَاتٍ مَنْ نَشَاءُ. Allah raised him levels in the paradise. Also, one of the specific criteria, وَتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا. He is Khalilul Rahman. Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام. And many times, I'm repeating this point, and still people answer the wrong. Okay, I think I mentioned this two times in the exam. Okay, Ibrahim is Khalilullah, and also Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is Khalilullah. Some of the brothers and sisters, they put false. Why? Because they say Ibrahim is Khalilullah, but Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is Habibullah. Okay, صح, Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is Habibullah, no doubt. And also Ibrahim is Habibullah. But also, we should say Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is Khalilullah. Khalil is higher than Habib. Al-Khulla is, the love has different levels. The highest level of love is called Khulla. Okay? This man is my friend, Sadiqi. This man is my companion, Sahibi. Maybe it is stronger, صح? Okay? So when I say this man is Khalili, it means Khalil from in wudu, okay? In wudu, maybe you read this in some books. Takhlil bayna al-asabi'. When you make wudu, make takhlil. What means takhlil? Like this. يعني make sure that the water goes inside, in between fingers. This is called takhlil. So the water goes inside. So what does it mean for Khalil? It means his love mixed inside my heart. Okay, so khulla, his love entered inside. So it is the highest level of love. So Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam is Khalilur Rahman, and also our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam is Khalilur Rahman. And also Ibrahim, Allah says, wa Ibrahim alladhi waffa. It means he fulfilled all of his duties. Whatever Allah told him, he fulfilled. He obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Waffa. Okay? He did not ignore anything from the rules of Sharia. Alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So these are some of the criteria came in the Quran and in the Sunnah. When man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then he said, Ya khayr al-bariyah. Ya khayr al-bariyah. What does it mean khayr al-bariyah? The best creation. One man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he said, "O Rasulullah, you are khayr al-bariyya, you are the best." Immediately the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "This is Ibrahim, not me." Okay, Ibrahim is the best. Of course, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said this yani as a humility. Okay? Or maybe during this moment he doesn't know that he is the best sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay, so no doubt this hadith means, okay, Ibrahim is the best one after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the best man, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and after him Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam. And also the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned a hadith about Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam at the day of judgment. As you know, Allah says, يُحْشَرُ النَّاسِ حُفَاتًا عُرَاتًا غُرْلًا. At the day of judgment, Allah will gather all the human beings. حُفَاتًا, barefoot. عُرَاتًا, naked. غُرْلًا, without circumcision. Okay? So, all the people. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will dress them. So, who will be the first one to be dressed? Ibrahim, alayhi salatu wasalam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أول من يكسى يوم القيامة إبراهيم. أول من يكسى. The first one to be clothed or covered, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. It doesn't mean that Ibrahim is better than the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay. If you are a teacher and you have students, okay, if I ask you, where is the first student? Well, I will tell you, for example, Abdullah. Okay, and the second, Muhammad. The third, Hussein. Maybe Hussein has 100 in English, but Abdullah has 95. Okay, but why Abdullah is the first? Overall. Okay, so the same thing. Overall, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the best. But there are certain criteria, other prophets better than him. Okay, yeah, for example, maybe we cannot say better than him, but they have advantage. Like the first one to be covered, Ibrahim, alayhi salatu wasalam. Another hadith about Musa, alayhi salatu wasalam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after the second blow, all the people will wake up, صح? Will come again to the life. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam said, "I will see Musa, alayhi salatu wasalam. I don't know, he woke up before me or he was not shocked." Okay, so this doesn't mean that Musa is better than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but in this point, طيب, and also about Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw him where? Which heaven in Isra al-Mi'raj? In the seventh heaven. In the night, the journey from Mecca to Jerusalem, then from Jerusalem to Masjid al-Aqsa high, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw the prophets. He saw Adam. He saw Yahya wa Isa. He saw Yusuf, the third. The fourth, Idris. The fifth, Harun. The sixth, Musa. The seventh, Ibrahim, alayhi salatu wasalam. So this is a very high level for Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam. طيب. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam started his da'wah with his family. The same way of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam when Allah revealed, وَأَنذِرْ عَشِرَتَكَ الْأَقْرَبِينَ. Allah told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, "You should warn your tribe, who are the close tribe." And he started sallallahu alayhi wasallam by calling his tribe. He called his uncle, Ya Abbas. He called his auntie Safiya, Ya Safiya. He called his daughter, Ya Fatima. So he started with his family, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, to warn them. And this is the correct way in da'wah. I should start with my family. Many times, subhanallah, you'll find da'iyah, they start outside not outside the house, outside the country, and they forget their family. Maybe he's calling people to, maybe he's calling people to salah, to the fasting, okay? And his son and his daughter, his wife, not praying. Subhanallah. Okay? You have to start with your family. Of course, I will not say you give da'wah only to your family. Start with your family. Because some people, the opposite. You'll find them only with their families. Okay? We ask them, okay, we have halqa tomorrow. We have halqa Tuesday. We have halqa Friday. We have halqa Thursday. We have halqa Saturday. He's not joining any halqa. Why? Well, I'm with my family. With my family. With my family. Yeah, okay, your wife made magic for you that you cannot leave the house. See? So, subhanAllah, some people always with the family. Any activity with his wife and children. Okay, it is good to be kind and you spend a lot of time with your family. But also you have to join the community outside. Okay, the Prophet ﷺ has nine wives, alayhi salatu wasalam. But also you can find him in the masjid, in the jihad, outside. Not only with family. Okay, some people, my family and my job, that's it. I said, this is wrong. You have to spend some time outside. So Allah says, وَأَنْدِرْ عَشِرَتَكَ الْأَقْرَبِينَ to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is the same way of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. He said, وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِبْرَاهِيمِ إِنَّهُ كَانَ صَدِّيقًا نَبِيًّا إِذْ قَالَ لِأَبِيهِ يَا أَبَتِ لِمَ تَعْبُدُ مَا لَا يَسْمَعُ وَلَا يُبْصِرُ وَلَا يُغْنِي عَنْكَ شَيْئًا. طيب. We'll talk about the da'wah of Ibrahim, inshallah, next halqa. جزاكم الله خير. صلى الله وسلم على محمد.
Would save, please save.
That's already in.
Yeah. Yesterday,
it came in. Yeah. Okay. After that,
so,